Upcoming, a huge project that will really cross boundaries when it comes to different generations, all involving women.
And inspire you to grow yourself and thus your life. Veda Ajamu, who is a criminal justice reform advocate and works at the National Civil Rights Museum. Welcome. Along with Sharolyn Payton, who's a life coach. Payton Place Coaching. I love the name.
Yes,
yeah, very cool there for sure.
So, inspired women inspire. That pretty much says it all. But do women do that? And let's just focus on the female gender right now. Or are we still competing with each other rather than lifting each other up? Veda?
So we do. We find ourselves competing with each other, but it's unnecessary. And what we should be doing is inspiring each other to push forward. And this is part of what we're going to be doing with Inspire Women Inspire, is to use the inspiration that you have gained through the years from other women, for myself, in fact. I take that and I pass that on to other women, and I think that's what we should be doing.
All boats rise.
Right.
Yes.
So, Sharolyn, when people are inspired, when they are uplifted and motivated by others, especially other women, what else can happen in a situation like that, especially when you're able to cross generational boundaries, racial boundaries, you name it?
We take the limits off. Basically, what we do when we give in those ways and support in those ways, not only do all boats rise, all boats start moving. And so we get a good wind in our sails to move forward with whatever we endeavor.
But how do you do that? So many people in general, no matter what your gender, sometimes we get in each other's way to help that other person out. How do we get there?
So we've talked about that. We want to become kind of the benchmark for how that's done. And here's what we're doing. We're giving the how-to of it. And a perfect example of that, when Veda shared with me as a coach her idea for Inspired Women, I was inspired. And my response to that was, have you done the back work to protect it? So how I supported her, instead of stealing her idea, I said, let's get the trademarking paperwork done. Let's move behind the scenes and get all these things in order. And then we reveal it. We give it to the world and let them know what your intent is. It's not new now. She's been doing this for a while, but didn't have the right support.
But because you have had your experience as a life coach, you knew that all that needed to be in place.
Exactly.
And you would have been in a position, because you do coach people for a living, to take the idea and run with it, maybe change the name a little bit. Is it because women have traditionally, in professional settings for many years, been a little disenfranchised? Is that why we sometimes fear that if you win, I lose?
We're afraid.
More than men,
we're afraid that there isn't enough. And we have this idea of the pie pieces. There are whole pies coming down a conveyor belt. Lots of pies. And if we can get other women to see that it's many pies, and we all need to engage this idea, we need to shift our paradigm. There is not scarcity, there is plenty.
How did you personally shift that paradigm for yourself?
Self-reflection and actually just looking at my world, and I'm saying, why do I believe that this person should be my competition? And when I look at myself and I look at women like Veda and I say, what if we got together? What if we merged our ideas, true collaboration? So I do a model of coaching called community coaching as well. This is built on the idea of leadership and collaboration. If everyone in a community comes together and does what they do,
their talent.
It's asset-based.
Sure.
And we all have value. We just have to look at each other.
You do have me also wondering, what can men, since we're also indirectly part of this variable, what can we learn as well from you?
Well, actually, you can be a great support for us in terms of even within the circle of men, there's also competition. So when you look at us as women to come together and support each other, and you support us as well, that's something that you can take back into your circle.
And this improves the entire community, doesn't it?
And it improves the entire community.
One particular way for this event, men have shown their support. We wanted to be economically inclusive, and some would say the price point was too high and all that sort of thing, which I don't think it is, but we asked men to sponsor women
That's
to have a space at the event who were economically challenged.
Okay.
And they all did.
All right.
That's awesome.
We can all learn for sure. Ladies, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Appreciate you being here.
Much.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
We will link to the Eventbrite link so you can sign up.